dad lived out in the country, and hardly anybody come out that way, but we were outside one day on the picnic table, and here come Jehovah's Witnesses clear out in the country. Amen. They don't care where you live. They'll come. Amen. And that's good for them. I mean, that's a good thing. We ought to be doing that, right? Amen. Even though they're bringing the wrong truth, I mean, wrong beliefs. 1 John 4:4. If you have found that, hopefully you got it marked in your Bible. If you don't have your Bible, it's here on the screen for you. It says, "Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in this world." This morning, I want to preach on the fact, because he lives, we can face 2017. Because he lives, you and I can face tomorrow and all that 2017 has in store for us. Let's pray. Father, I thank you, Lord, for your presence, your power, God, that I already feel here this morning. I pray, God, that you'd anoint me and use me, God, for the next few moments, God, to bring forth your word today. God, not my words, but God, your words, under the unction of the Holy Ghost. God, anoint every ear to hear, every heart to receive, Father, your word with gladness. I pray right now, in the name above every name, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says, "Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in this world." Amen. Do you understand this morning who you got living on the inside of you today? Do you understand, church, who you got living in you today? Amen. We got the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords living in our hearts and lives. If you have come to a place in your life and you have asked God to forgive you of your sins, amen, Jesus Christ, amen, dwells on the inside of us. Amen. And my Bible says that greater is he that is in me than he that is in this world. Amen. We sing that old song, "Because he lives, I can face tomorrow." Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Amen. And I believe this morning, because he lives, amen, you and I can face, amen, whatever 2017 throws our way. Amen. We're sitting in a place right now that nobody else has ever sit in. Amen. Some of you have been serving God for 40, 50 years, but there ain't nobody that's walked through 2017 that can stand up today and say, "I know what it's going to be like. I know what lies ahead." Amen. There ain't nobody in here that's been in 2017 yet. If you have, amen, you better leave, because I don't want to talk to you. No. But it's nice to know when somebody can walk up beside you and say, "I've already been there." Amen. But can I tell you today, there's nobody in this building that's been there yet. We don't know what tomorrow holds. We don't know what next month holds. We don't know what's going to happen, amen, when the next president comes in. We don't know what's going to happen, amen, 2 months from now. Amen. But I came to tell somebody, amen, I serve a God, amen, that knows all. I serve a God, amen, that he can do all things, and he's already been there. He knows what 2017 holds for us. Amen. Some people are nervous. Some people are scared. Some people are fearful. Amen. But I came to tell you today, don't worry. Amen. Don't get nervous. Just know that who lives inside of you, amen, is going to help you through every step that you take, every mountain you climb, every valley you walk through. Amen. If you'll get a hold of his hand and you understand who lives in me, Brother Marvin. Amen. My God is greater. My God is mightier. He is all powerful today. And God will see you through. Amen. Whatever Satan throws your way. Amen. If you get a hold of God and you hold on to God, amen, God will help you kick the devil right square in the teeth today. Huh? He don't belong on your shoulders. He belongs under our feet today. But too many people have allowed him to get on their shoulders, amen, and allowed the devil to get in their ear and begin to lie to them and tell them it's not important anymore. But it is important. We can't do this in ourselves. We can't do this by ourselves. Amen, because if we do, we're going to make a mess of it. But if we'll get a hold of God and we'll get a hold of his hand and we understand who we have with us, amen, we can do whatever happens in 2017. Amen? You believe that today? Hey, amen? We don't know what 2017 has in store for us. We don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. Amen. Tomorrow may bring heartache. Tomorrow may bring pain. Tomorrow may bring sickness. Amen. Tomorrow may bring job loss. Tomorrow may bring depression. Tomorrow may bring discouragement. Amen. But whatever tomorrow comes, amen, it brings our way. If we'll know that we know that we know, amen, that God lives in me. And whatever comes my way, amen, my God is greater. My God is stronger. My God is more powerful. And my God will give me the ability, amen, to fight off depression. Amen. To fight off discouragement. Amen. To find another job if I lost my job. Amen. God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, more than we can even imagine and think. Huh? But so many times we focus on the situation. We focus on the sickness. We focus on the job loss. We focus on the problem. Amen. And we forget who we serve. God is bigger than your job loss. God is bigger than your marital problems. Amen. God is bigger than your sickness today. Amen. My Bible says, amen, greater is He that is in me. He that is in you today is greater than whatever we got to face. Amen. Hallelujah. You may have had a rough, terrible 2016. You may have had the worst year you ever had. You need to stand up this morning and tell the devil, I made it. I made it. I made it. I made it. I got out of 2016 and I'm going to make a better 2017. Oh yes, I may have went through hell and high water. I may have walked in some dark places. Amen. But I made it. I made it. I made it. I made it. 2016 is behind me. And now I'm looking for better things in 2017. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give God a hand clap of praise. 2016 may have brought you in the valley, amen, but 2017 is going to bring you up into a mountain experience. If you understand who's in you, who's with you, He has not forgotten you, He has not forsaken you, amen. When we get in darkness and we get in valleys, amen, we feel all alone sometimes, amen, but I came to remind you, amen, that God is still with you even in the midst of bad times. Huh? God don't run when trouble comes. Huh? God don't run, amen, when heartache comes. Amen. God don't run, amen, when problems begin to arise. Amen. God, amen, is still God, even when problems are all around us. Amen. We need to look within ourselves and say, I have God in me, and greater is He that is in me than these problems that I'm having to deal with. Amen. 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 I believe we ought to declare in 2017, amen, we're going to be victors and not victims. Huh? Victors and not victims. Amen. We've been victims, amen, long enough. Amen. But my God is a victorious God. And if He lives in me, then I can be victorious in 2017. Kick the devil in the face and tell him I've had enough. I want victory in 2017. Huh? Come on. I want victory in 2017. I've seen some of you go through stuff this year that brought heartache and pain to your lives, that brought heartache and pain to my life. Amen. But I'm glad you're still here. I'm glad you're still serving God. I'm glad you didn't give up. Amen. Because there ain't nothing to give up and go back to. Hold on. Hold on. God's greater. God's going to see you through. Amen. Hallelujah. My God is greater. My God is stronger. My God is mightier today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need to begin 2017 and we need to understand that I am of God and I am His child. I didn't say I am a God. I am of God. He's my Father and I'm His child. Amen. Isn't what the scripture said? You are of God, little children, and have overcome them because greater is He that is in you. Amen. We need to understand that I am of God. He is my Father. How many knows God ain't a deadbeat father? He ain't no deadbeat father. He ain't laying around while you're in trouble and while you're hurting. Amen. He's a father, amen, that'll be there, amen, when nobody else will be there. When you've fallen down and you can't get up, he's there to pick you up. Amen. When your family has forsaken you and said you're no good, amen, God says there's some good. Get up. We're God's child, and he's our father. I believe God has a plan already laid out for you in 2017. He has it all laid out. And if we'll get a hold of him, amen, even when we walk through the valley, amen, he'll walk through the valley with you. Even when you go to the fire. How many remember Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Amen, they were thrown into the fiery furnace. Amen, the fire was so hot. Amen, the men that threw them in the fire fell to the ground as dead men. Amen, but even in the midst of the fire, amen, Jesus showed up in the fire. And the Bible says, doesn't it look like there's four men in the fire? That fourth man looks like the Son of God. Amen, Jesus won't leave in the midst of the fire. He'll stay with you even in the furnace. If you hold on to him. You got to hold on to him. But so many times we get in the fire. We get in the midst of struggle. And we look at the fire. We look at the struggle. And we forget who's in us and whose we are. My Father owns it all. My Father can speak a word and cancer can fall off today. My God can speak a word, amen, and take a life that's broken and put it back together. My God can take a heart that's black with sin and wash it in the red blood of Jesus and make it white as snow. Amen. Thank God for our brother that came here last night. He said he's looking to change his life. Amen. This is the place. Amen. Give your life to God. Serve God. And your life will be changed today. How many can say God has changed my life this morning? Lift your hand up. Say, God has changed my life. Hallelujah. Now I'm a child of God. I'm not the man I used to be. I'm not the drunk I used to be. I'm not the no good nothing I used to be. You may think I'm still no good, but can I tell you today, I got royal blood flowing through my veins. Amen. I'm a child of the King today. My God owns it all, and he's my Father. Amen. And he's yours too. Hallelujah. Acts 17, verse number 28. It says, for in him we live and move and have our being, as certain also of your own poets have said, for we are also his offspring. Amen. We're, hallelujah, offsprings of the Father. Amen. As we begin 2017, let us know and understand that we live and we move and we have our being because of him. It's not about me. It's not about what I can do. It's about what God can do in me. I live. I move. He is my being. He's my everything today. You try to live 2017 half-hearted for God, you're going to live like this. You live 100% for God. Amen. You can live on the mountain sometimes, but sometimes you got to go in the valley. But even in the valley, you can still have joy in your heart because you know everything's right between you and God. Because he's in me. He's behind me. He's in front of me. He's everywhere I go. He's all around me. I live. I move. In my being, he's everything. Amen. As we begin 2017, let's understand. Amen. Don't try to evolve your life around God. Evolve your life around God. That makes sense? Live your life around God. Not I live my life and then God fits in. Live your life. Excuse me. God first, and then me. Amen, because we understand I can't live without him. I can't move without him. I can't make a decision without him. As you begin 2017, understand that we live, we move, amen, and we are our being because of him. Amen, every purchase that you make, amen, ask God first. Every decision that you make, ask God first. Every time you get paid, put God first. Every time you do something, amen, you understand I'm God's and he's mine. So I got to ask my Father, is it okay? You do that, you'll be blessed. I'm not talking here, I'm talking here. Right here. Blessed in your heart. Amen. Why? Because you have sought God first, and God will lead, and God will direct, and God will provide, and God will take care of us if we understand where he is on our priority list. And he should be number one. We may think, well, I can make this decision by myself. I don't need God. I believe we ought to pray about every decision we make. Amen? Every purchase we make. We ought to pray and ask God, well, you go get some gum. No, don't pray about gum. Should I get sugar-free or sugar? That's your problem. No. I'm talking about big decisions. When we go spend some money, we need to pray and seek God first. Amen? All right, moving on. I'm losing you. You don't like that. That's all right. We need to understand God's everything. He should be in everything we do. Everything we do. Amen? Wherever we go, He should be in our minds that God's with me. So whatever I'm looking at, whoever I'm talking to, whatever I'm listening to, He's with me. He's with me. He's everywhere. So whatever I'm listening to, He's listening to. Huh? Whatever I'm looking at, He's looking at. If we remember this in everything we do, amen, you're going to have a better 2017, can I tell you? Amen. We need to understand that the more of Him we get, the stronger we become. The more of Jesus we get, the stronger we become. Huh? The more word you get, the stronger you get. The more time you spend in prayer, the stronger you get. The more time you come into His house, amen, the stronger you get. Too many people have allowed, amen, other things to become priorities, amen, between their time they spend with God. Amen. We've allowed work schedules. We've allowed children. We've allowed pleasures. We've allowed other things to come between us and God in 2016. How many knows we need to wipe the slate clean and say 2017, amen, I'm putting God first. I'm going to spend time in the Word. I'm going to spend time in prayer. And I'm going to spend time in God's house every chance I get. Amen. Praise God. Put Him first. He'll bless you. Put Him second. You're on your own. How many knows He won't take second place? Amen. Many people have made New Year's resolutions last night. They say that I won't do this, I will do that, or they made many New Year's resolutions. But I challenge you today, don't make a New Year's resolution. Make a new commitment to the Lord.